Alright YouTube, so I'm starting out the video on the computer here, putting some stuff together in the cart for Blaze's pit bike. I already got a clutch lever and a shifter in there. I don't think I need anything else. I'm just going to go to the local shop and just get a chain for that, and then the pipe I should be able to fix myself. So we're going to go over the whole bike. I'm going to give you a rundown on what actually broke, fix the pipe, and then maybe ride pit bikes. I don't know. For right now, I got to figure out whatever else I need to order and put it all in the cart so I can get this thing ordered. All right, so coming back out to the garage, we're gonna inspect this thing. I'm gonna take off the side plate, and then I think I fixed up the chain. I just straightened out the chain a little bit. I'm gonna take off the shifter, just bend it back temporarily until the new one comes in. Then the clutch, before when Blaze had it, I think he did dump it since the fender was already broken. I didn't break, well, I broke it a little bit more, but it was already broken. And when you pulled the clutch in when he had it, it was actually like above the bar, like he bent it up. So it kind of actually bent it down to how it was supposed to be, but it still kind of pushes back a little bit. I'm gonna order a new one anyway, just to have a fresh one on there. It's all scraped up and whatnot, but yeah, honestly I think I fixed it, but whatever. But the main concern right now is the pipe and bending this whole thing back and the shifter and whatnot. If they are bent and Blaze thinks they're tweaked a little bit, I'll order him a new set of bars, because I did think he said he wanted a little bit taller bars. I'm not entirely sure. Alongside the pipe, if the pipe can't be fixable, I gotta hook up on a stock pipe that I'll just buy. It's basically a brand new stock pipe. The kid took it off after using, or after having his 110 for like a day, just put an aftermarket pipe on there. So just come off the, there we go. All right. Well, I guess I may as well take the seat off while I'm at it. That way I can actually. Okay. So looks like I'm going to probably take the fender off and zip tie that up also. But it looks like all the only thing that bent was the actual, the frame. So that looks like I can easily bend that back with a, holding on to it, maybe a little bit of heat. And regardless, I'd have to take out the fender since it would melt the plastic. Try and take this pipe off, since taking this whole rear fender off looks like it's gonna be a pain. I don't know why there's so many different bolts to take off the rear fender and everything, but it's a pain, looks like, at least, to take all the battery and all this crap out. So we'll see if it can just do this without taking it off, and then I'll just zip tie the fender on the bike. So just to bend the pipe back, I pushed it down in place, if you can see that. And then all I gotta do now is heat this, heat the frame up, and then just bend it back down straight so this will line up straight and it won't be all like off and up and the way it was before. I get this on here before I start heating it up, so that way, I might actually, I can probably just bend it right now, yeah. Bend this back. Don't even need to use heat. Take this off. There we go. We'll see how that lines up. Lock this on. Keep bending it out without breaking it off. We'll tighten this back up. Well, as far as zip ties go, you just kind of drill a bunch of holes in a line, stitch it up. There's really not much to it, so we'll start drilling some holes here. Fender's better than new, I'd say, to be honest. Doesn't flex. Go through. That's no good. Slide the bad boy back on. Slide that into place. Oval out or something. But when I put the, use the impact back in, you can kind of tell going slow if it's gonna like cross thread or whatnot. But that's just from my experience. Good as new. Almost good as new. Now all we got left is the shifter. We'll take that off, straighten that up. All right, loosen this up, take the shifter off. That thing's a little bit bent in. Nothing we can't fix though, temporarily. Plop it in like this, or like this. Tighten it down. There we go. If I had some room over here with all the chairs in my way, but looks like we're sliding out too. Tighten it back down. Should be good. Didn't even have to use a mallet, hammer, or nothing. It's pretty good. It's pretty straight, if you can see that. Maybe I'll tweak it a little bit more. All right, slide this thing back on. Might have to bend it up now, then I bent it out, it bent down a little bit. Zipper's all good, I'll tighten down.
Yeah, I'm gonna do really quick is flip the zip ties so the clip part is on the inside and it's just wrapped around on the outside. It'll just look a little bit cleaner. I didn't really think about that when I was putting these outer ones on that you actually see and not the ones under the seat. Everything seems to be good. Rotor down the lawn, pipe's good. Everything else is good. The bars may be, now that I was riding it, they might be tweaked a little bit on the side it fell on. They're a little bit off. Look into those. I'll hit up Lacey if he wants the Mika bars. If not, I'll get him a different set of bars. We'll hop on this thing. It's already been warmed up. I was just ripping it around the lawn, but everything still seems to be good. Actually, let me shut this off. I just ordered up some Mika Metal pit bike low bars. I believe those are the in-between. They might be a little bit taller than these bars themselves, and then you can always put like a bar riser on there if you really wanted to. I actually ordered up another set of the same bars with a different bar pad for something coming soon, very soon, maybe, we'll see. You guys will have to stay on the lookout for that. So if you guys are new, definitely hit the subscribe button down below and you'll see what that is shortly.
That's the rip in the sandy part now that it's done.
Oh, chain fell off.
Well, actually the chain didn't fall off. The chain actually snapped off by the looks of it.
That only took about 3 minutes of riding, if that. So I guess I'll push it back. Luckily I didn't make it too far. And I'll run to the store and grab a new chain.
I just got back from the store. Got the chain. I'm gonna have to split it because it's I think it's 130 link or something. Anyways, we'll size it up. Needed a new chain anyway. If you saw the video where I crashed it, the chain got all bent up and it twisted, and then I just took the chain off the other day and hammered it down to straighten it out, knowing that I still needed a chain. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do with what you got. Now I'll just put it in the thing and then I'll use the punch it out. Maybe I should have invested in a chain splitter at this point, but this has worked for me.
Hey, well, chain's all good to go. Put it up, turn the gas back on, and we should be good.
Might have to adjust it a little bit, but for the most part, maybe just back it off like 3 or 4 turns.
I always keep forgetting this thing is a kickstand. None of them have it.
I'm just gonna do a couple little jib, whatever things in the front. I don't know.
Finally, now that I got the chain fixed, we're out here the next day, or current day that you're watching this video, actually the morning, it's like 10 o'clock, riding around. I figured I'd put this GoPro in today's video. So before I film today's video of riding at the track, but mess around on the pit bike for a little bit, go inside, edit the video, and then go to the track later. A little bit muddy, it just rained. I'll go ride the actual main trails back there in a minute. That'd be cool to jump from there to there, but it's so hard in between these two trees. If I cut out those trees, maybe if I cut one of these big trees right here and get it out of the way, but jump from that hill down into this and then jump down into this and cut this, that'd be kind of cool. And these ones. At least our little bridge thing is still there. Little bar. All right. It's really slippery. So slippery. Long trail.
this hill, try and cut out all this. There's a big tree right there, but we can loop it in another trail and have this kind of cut out all these trees and make this kind of a jump up, or you can jump and like turn down and cut all the vines. I know for sure, cut out all these little guys, cut out all this stuff. It's not too much work. And then have a little jump from like the bottom, jump over. I think it'd be kind of fun. At least add like one jump back here, because this is like the only hill, and then everything else aside from where we've been riding is like all wetlands and crap. And aside from the trails to actually get here, we can add some more trails. And then there's like a big pond right there, so there's a little bit of area, but not too much. But for pit bikes, you don't really need too much space, and we could add a couple little jumps in the main trail thingy we've made. But probably another couple days back here, we could have a full, like a longer loop aside from what we already have. It all takes time, and obviously the more people we get back here to help, the quicker we can build trails. And if it's just me by myself, or just me and Justin or something, and then if we have like two more people, we could really get some work done back here and get some trails. But we're trying to figure out as far as pit bikes, who's all gonna get a pit bike, because I think Mike's trying to get a pit bike, Anthony's gonna try to get a new pit bike, Bankus, Bailey might get a pit bike, I'm gonna try to get a pit bike, Phil might get a pit bike. So yeah, and then once Blaze gets healed up, we'll have, what is that, 5, 6, 7, maybe 8 people, and then the other Bailey, the other Kyle, we'd have like maybe almost 10 people with pit bikes to like mob. So that'd be mad fun if all of them get pit bikes. But we'll figure it out. Hopefully soon enough now that the weather's starting to get nice and we can finally ride them. Head back now, hit that other jump. By my house. It's kind of boring to ride back here by myself, and I want to make more trails. Those ones are kind of getting boring already, to be honest. So I've ridden them so much. Aside from the vlogs, I've ridden them a couple times by myself. Believe it or not, I don't film everything I do, so I do ride sometimes and not film it. The trail getting here is kind of a little tight. Maybe we'll actually cut this tree out, since if you fall that way, you're going into a deep, slimy pond that, if your bike falls in that, it's gonna be pretty hard to get it out. And that'll suck. So we gotta cut that. Chain from yesterday. Just leave that here. Little jib jump. Little pace. It's like I fall and go right into the pond. That would suck. There we go. These things are so fun. It's so like not a crazy amount of power. You can just ease on the throttle, have fun on it. It's not crazy loud. There we go. And we'll wrap it up. All right, so I'm gonna wrap up this video right now, start the next vlog after I edit this video. Hopefully today I'm gonna break out the 250, go ride that, have a little fun on that, leave the 125 home. And yeah, I'm gonna close the video out here. If you guys enjoyed it, definitely smash the subscribe button down below. Give this video a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in the next one.